over. I just want to let you know we do have some munchies, so there's some menus on the thing if you guys need. But we're going to bring up the wonderful Onae, as we pronounce ah, like Onae. Still, even though as open as you are, you're going to get psychic amnesia, okay? Psychic amnesia is where I'm going to tell you that your Uncle Albert put the key in the vase right next to the door, and there's going to be the map to the safe that's going to have all the millions. And you're going to be like, a vase? Uncle Albert? I don't know anything. And then you're going to go home, and you're going to be like, oh my gosh, there's a picture of Uncle Albert right there next to the vase with the key in it with the map. Millions. Okay, and you're going to be like, oh my gosh.
Thank you.
So that's what's going to happen. That's what's going to happen here. So don't worry. But what I need you to do is even though you're not understanding it, and it's not clicking, and you're stressing, you're going to accept it. So just accept it. You'll understand it when you get there, when you leave. All right, also another thing that happens here is called piggybacking. Spirit likes to piggyback. You guys were all brought here tonight. So with that, Spirit brings you together. So you might have an Uncle Bob. You might have an Uncle Bob. And I'll be like, Uncle Bob's here. And I'll get some kind of symbols or messages. And what you're going to need to do is you're just going to have to grasp that and hold on to it. I might be talking to her over here, but you can still raise your hand over here and tell me that you've got an Uncle Bob, okay? I will get more detail, and then I'll know which Uncle Bob I'm going to, all right? But that doesn't mean it's not your Uncle Bob, okay? So if you are feeling, if I'm talking over here, and you're feeling as if you're getting the message and it belongs to you, it is your message, because I'm going to try as best I can to get to every one of you, okay, and give you a direct message, but just because I don't talk to you specifically, doesn't mean you're not getting the message. Alright? You understand? Okay. Alright. I just want everybody to know because I don't want anybody to think that they're not getting their message. Just because I don't talk to you specifically. Alright, so just a little bit of history about me if you haven't already. I was born and raised in a family of intuitives and tarot card readers. My Aunt Beverly, she's here with me right now. Thank you, Aunt Bev. Raised me with the tarot cards and the intuition from the Irish side. So, with that, I was raised this way. So I can see, but I got the lion's share of the abilities. So I can see, hear, feel, sense, taste, know, and understand things, and I can remote view. And I can also talk to those that have crossed over. I see shadow figures. I can see and feel other entities that are not even, that you can't see with the bare eye. I can see here, I get messages, I hear things. See things, I can actually see figures in all different ways. Okay, so if I'm going to be explaining something to you, just grasp it the best you can and make the best sense you can of it and know that it's for you. And I basically am raising my own family in the same way. I have tarot cards on my table. Tarot cards are not evil, guys. They're beautiful, individual pieces of art, just so you know. What you need to work on and divide is basically who is using these things. These are just tools. And I'm telling you that because I'm a tarot card reader. People are like, ooh, tarot cards. So just want you to know. All All right, so we have the piggybacking. We have the psychic amnesia. And I'm probably forgetting something because I'm probably having psychic amnesia right now. So anyway, I'm going to get started. And my name's Onae, and you are?
Mike.
Hi, Mike.
Hard of hearing.
Oh, okay, you're hard of hearing. Okay. No, I just forgot who you were. Maybe you should. Maybe that spirit's saying you should eat a chocolate. All right, so let's. All right, can we get some people, please, here? They're still showing me Chuck Wagon. So there's something about the name Chuck or Wagon. Did you go on a wagon ride? Or you just Chuck something named Chuck and Wagon? Chuck Wagon. Okay. Just hold on to it. If that or tomorrow you need to order a Chuck Wagon burger, okay, because they won't let go of that, and that I think it's for you. They keep looking at you and they keep saying Chuck Wagon. So did you go on a wagon? They're showing me a wagon. They're like, in a wagon. And I'm like, in a field, like a grassy field. Did you go on a wagon ride at all recently?
No.
Do you plan it? Are you planning on going on one?
No, I don't think so. All
right, hold on to that then. Who's David?
No, I don't think so.
All right, hold on to that then. Who's David? Who has David?
David is your boss.
David is your boss.
David's your boss.
He's still alive.
Yeah.
Okay. We can have alive people. I can say a name of a live person, and it's okay. All right? I'm just trying to identify a message for you. So this could be somebody coming through for that person that is connected to you. Okay?
I got an Uncle David.
You got an Uncle David. All right.
Okay.
David, you've got a David.
I've got three.
You've got three David.
I only got one.
We got one, three, and a boss named David. And you got a David.
Wow. Oh, boy. I didn't mess with
you. I have a friend named
David.
Oh,
boy.
I didn't mess with you.
David. All right, who's got a J name with a David? J name.
DJ.
DJ. That's the name, David.
David's name is DJ, yes.
What does the cherry mean? The cherry. He's showing me a cherry, like a maraschino cherry or something. I got a cherry. Cherry tree. Is that your favorite song? Is that his favorite song, Cherry Tree? don't know, that Rose of the Cherry Tree song, that whatever.
He likes music.
The music, is that the song? Is that, like, does he sing that? Did he sing that? What's going on here with this cherry tree?
I have no clue.
Cherry tree. I got a horse with a cherry tree. And go back to Chuck right now. So hold on to the cherry and then hold on to that. No, he's showing me a cherry. Is that like someone's name? Sherry, cherry, cherry. I got cherry. I'm being shown a cherry. Was there like a pattern? Did somebody wear a dress with cherries on it? Is there curtains with cherries on it? I'm seeing this. They're showing me cherries. What is your name anyway?
Katie.
Okay, you told me cherry. I'd be like freaking out. Showing me cherries. He will not stop with the cherries. Does cherries mean anything to anybody else? Cherries on fabric. Cherries on something. Cherries. I'm seeing cherries.
That's what I can see.
Did you win cherries on a slot machine?
Yeah. I wish.
Okay.
Maybe he's going to get
you. Maybe I will.
You've got the list, though. They're telling me it's OCD kind of. We got listy because you have to have your list. But you have list upon list. Like everything has to have a list. You have to have everything in order. So now who is? They're still telling me cherry, and there's somebody wagging with you. I don't know why this. You gotta claim this, man. You gotta claim this wagon. So I'm gonna get back to you because they won't stop with the cherries every time I look at you. I see a cherry. Do you like cherries? Did you make cherries? Do you drink Shirley Temples and have a cherry? Like what is this? Did you just Is this your first time here having a psychic reading? Is it by popping your cherry?
I do. Yeah, this is my first time.
They won't stop with the cherries. So now know that this is something, that this is new for you. So, and DJ is still here, or has DJ passed over?
He's still here.
He's still here. So who is connected? Is it a woman that is connected to the two of you with DJ?
Yes.
Okay. She's here. Now, does she wear dresses all the time?
I don't know her right
now. You don't know?
I don't know her that well.
Okay. Yeah, because I'm getting a picture. I have a picture of her in a dress. And it's just under her knees, and I feel like she was wearing something kind of like nursing shoes or those older or more comfortable shoes. I'm feeling like she was definitely older when she did pass. So whoever this is, I don't know if this is mom or aunt or grandma that is more like a mom kind of person with DJ. Is this making sense to you?
Not really, because his mom's still alive.
Okay, so this is grandma or an aunt. Yes? No? What? No. Are we all alive here? Are we all alive? Or do we have anybody that's deceased that's like like a female in the family?
An aunt.
Okay. So I have a picture of a woman and she's wearing a dress. She's wearing, I don't know if she's a nurse or something, or she worked in a restaurant because she's showing me the shoes are really important along with the dress. I don't know why I'm getting this, but I also kind of feel like there's an apron around there too. So either she worked in a restaurant or something like that, or she liked to cook, known as the cook.
Okay.
Shay, is that making sense to you now?
Making sense,
okay,
yes.
Thank you. So know that she's here, and if this is for DJ, then know that DJ is being watched over. She's taking on the Garden Angel role, and she still shows and smells the scent of cooking. I feel like whenever you smell the baking or the cooking, I feel like I'm... Did she make a cherry? Did she put cherries? Oh, did she make... Look at that. What is that bread wrap that they made at Christmas? Is there anything in particular that you need to be working on right now that you haven't worked on that you've been snapping on?
Probably just the house.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because they're making me feel like I gotta do it, I gotta get it done, I gotta get it done. So
it's
you're
only
gonna be getting
here.
So is there anybody that you want to talk to in particular?
Maybe my grandmother.
Your grandmother. Okay, what's her name?
Lillian.
Okay. vines with white flowers? Okay. But she's showing me her flowers now. So this is how she, you know her. Does flowers have a specific smell? Okay. So know that when you smell that, have you smelled that lately? Because she's making me feel like you have smelled these lately. Okay. Know that the veil is thin right now because we're close to Halloween and All Hallows Eve and All Saints Day and All Souls Day. That all comes together. Okay. So get all the religions we can. Okay. Cover all bases. So know that this is the veil is the thinnest right now. Okay. And so you're going to start to smell, and you know her presence is there for you. Okay. And she's paying attention to you, and she's trying to give you a message that you need to get moving on something. So you've been delaying on something, you're procrastinating, even though you like to make lists and you like to get things done. In your state, you need to get this done, she's saying. She's kind of encouraging you. So when you're thinking about something and also you smell the roses, that is her telling you, I'm watching you and I'm encouraging you. You need to get moving. Okay? And I'm getting a chuck wagon.
You need to
do like a pioneer thing. Or do you do pioneer days or something? Do you do pioneers? Do you act out? Like, what do you do? What do you do with this chuck wagon thing? In the grass.
I work on cars every day.
You work on cars every day?
Every day.
But not a wagon. Do you work on a station wagon?
No.
Okay. I'm just checking.
Station wagon.
I'm trying to find the wagon thing inside the wagon up here in the sky. Okay. But you like wagons? You do things with wagons?
No.
Oh. All right. I've been talking about that the whole time you've been again. All right. This is how you're doing.
I see.
Okay. And what's your name,
huh? Amber.
Hi, Amber. Is there anyone you'd like to talk to in particular?
Maybe my stepfather.
Okay. And what's his name?
Al.
Al. Okay. I remember that song. His name's Al. Who's that singer? Now, I took that song in my head.
Right.
Your confidence. You know that, right? Come on out. Alright, what's up with the pub? This is a pub. P-U-B. Pub. Paps. P-A-B.
That would be my husband.
Yeah. Is he here?
No, he's at home.
Oh, he's down the hill. So your stepdad is talking about your husband. Then.
Okay,
so we're connected. All right.
Thank you. All right.
So anyway, know that he's here and he's with you and he's watching over your husband now. He built this bar.
My husband built the bar, yeah.
Okay. Know that he's here and he's with you and he's watching over your husband now. He built this bar.
My husband built the bar, yeah.
Do you have spittoons or something in there? What's up with this?
These parts, but not the
Okay, did you find that you have like a brass? I don't want to say a vase because I feel like it's bigger than that. I almost kind of. I don't know.
I have vessel. It's
okay.
A wide mouth.
That's what
it's
I'm
not
saying.
A spittoon.
Okay, so
if I think it's more like a plant or because of around the
Okay, was it used as a spittoon at one time? Was it like an antique or something? Because
it could be.
Okay, did you just plant something in this? Or were you planning on planting something in this? Okay, because I'm feeling like there's like either some kind of rose bush or a tree of some sort that you need to be planting in this. I don't know what that means. Maybe in honor of this person, but or Al. Okay. What's up with the bench? Do you have a special bench for him? Or a special spot?
Yes.
Okay. And you sit next to him when you talk to him? Do you feel like he's next to you when you talk to him?
Well, the bench is in Michigan.
Okay. So but when you're speaking with him, do you feel like he's with you?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, because he's making me feel like he rubs up against the left side of you when he's sitting next to you. He's right there by you. So pay attention to that. And also, you get a tingling in your ear, the left ear. He's giving me that silent symbol. Sensation. So when you're listening and talking to him, listen because this is happening. He's going to tug on your hair.
Okay.
If If you're not paying attention, it's the tingle in your ear. It's going to tug on your head. Does that happen to you?
Okay.
If the left, it's making sure it's the left one. You have to pay attention to the left one. I don't know why, because typically the left side is the female side. But, oh, okay. All right, so he's making sure that he needs the left side.
Yeah.
Do you have a question for him? And yes, he's proud.
That'd be mom. It is avoidable. And she said something with food, and she's waving her stick at me. So it's something to do with food. So whatever this is, pay attention to your diet, because it's can be controlled with that. Yeah.
And I'm going to leave that with you, honey, and I hope that helps. What's your name?
Me?
Chris. Yeah, you. Chris. Yeah. Chris. Hi, Chris.
Hi.
Is there anybody you'd like to talk to tonight?
No.
What?
No.
No? Were you dragged here, hon?
Yeah.
Were you made a remake? Were you trying to hide behind her?
No, she was just
going to be a convenient
person.
Sure, guys, his wife
keeps telling me. So you don't want me to talk to you?
No, I'm good. For a long period of time.
You won't talk to me. And Kristen, sure. Yeah. Diane.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hi.
Would you like to talk to
my mother?
Your mother?
Yeah, she died last
week. What's the number 12 mean to you?
Just
Ruth Nelson Hawks.
It means something to that.
I might be happy to see you guys' video.
Number 12.
Oh.
She loved football.
Oh.
And awesome. Number 12 is the Seahawks.
It's been doing
okay.
That the whole time.
Yeah, love football.
Your birthday was in December.
Well, that too. But the Seattle Seahawks is number 12.
What's the number 6 mean to you?
Number 6?
Mm-hmm.
My birthday is December 5th, but my mother's birth month is June. And her middle name is June, and my middle name is June. And I always said, you need to call me Diane December. I was born in December. Anyway, I don't know.
You know that she's here and she's going to be with you on yours and your mother's birthday, okay? She's giving you presents, okay? And that's a little box. And she's showing me green wrapping paper and red ribbon. So I don't know what that represents as far as other than Christmas. I don't know if you celebrate Christmas or not. But it shows me here that you are getting something and she's saying it's having sex and she's putting wings on it. So if you have not received something already, it will be coming in the mail.
That's my mother.
I don't know what that means,
my mother always sent me gifts because I moved to Reno, and she always sent me gifts. And I'm going to Spokane because that's where I'm originally from, and I had a bench built for my mother's grave, and I haven't seen it, and I'm going next in a week and a half.
So,
I'm sending her a gift, and she's sending me one back.
Okay, yeah, but she says it's in the mail. I don't know what that means. You're getting something in the mail.
Yeah.
I don't know what that means. Yeah. So if that resonates with you for some reason, it's coming. Or she's did you mail something? Did you do something with the mail?
Mom and I always sent stuff in the mail all the time because I live in Spokane. She lives in Spokane. I live in Reno.
Apparently, I have to accept this message.
That's kind of
crazy. I'm getting stuck in the mail. But she's saying something in the mail. She keeps saying it over and over in my head. So no, that's mom, okay?
Okay.
But she's going to be with you. She's saying on her birthday. What are you doing on her birthday? Do you do something specifically on her birthday?
We always went on vacation on her birthday.
So then know that when you plan that trip that you're going to be going on in honor of her birthday, she's going to be right there with you. Now, did you just go on a cruise or are you planning a cruise?
We're planning a cruise.
Okay, she's going to be there with you. Are you going to Alaska?
No, we went to Alaska in 2001 because that was where she always wanted to go.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Mom. Okay. So mom's here. Do you have a question for her?
No, I don't have a question for her, but just tell her how much I love her.
She heard you. She's right here with you, hon. She's giving me little heart emojis. I don't know if she did that or not.
She texted before she died.
I'm not talking to Chris.
You really should die here.
We got a truck wagon here, so. I'm going to figure this one out. You have to pay attention, and you have to, I'm going to give you my phone number. So that when you leave here and you're like, oh, truck wagon, I remember now. Who would you like to talk to?
I don't know. How about my grandma?
Okay. Did her name start with an I or like an I sound? So I want to say Inez.
No.
So I sound. Her name was Mary. Not an I sound. Right. Who do you know that has an I name? That like an I? Because I'm not making Mary fit with Inez. So we're just. I, Idaho, Iowa, I don't know. So that's what their sign is for you, the chuck wagon. Okay?
Okay.
I'm not trying to make that fit, but if that makes sense to you, now. We're going to leave that with you. Sally likes you. Do you go there often? You.
Me.
Yeah. Okay. The name Sally came to me again. And I feel like I don't know. It says Sally likes you and you go there often.
So
I don't know what that means. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
And then it rang a bell the next morning.
Oh.
Because I had a private reading about 3 weeks before you.
Okay.
And there was a little problem like you mentioned.
Okay. I'm glad she likes you. And you go there often. So where do you go that where she would be connected to you somehow?
The other reading was about this marriage.
Okay. That's why she likes you. But what's number 3 have to do with it?
Still not.
Third?
We have 2 kids.
She would have been your third?
She would have been in between the first and the second.
So that's
you back in another way. How old are your children?
20 and 27.
Okay, so one of them pregnant right now.
Then he knows.
Are you sending your family to get off?
I don't know. I'm not that well. I'm
sure. So know that they're both here. Do you have a question for either of them? No? Just want to know if they're here? All right, then I'll leave that with you, honey. I hope that helps. What's up with the pretzel, though? Do you like pretzels or something? Do you eat a pretzel? Do you make pretzels?
No.
Do you take the salt off your pretzels?
No.
Who takes the salt off their pretzels? New York. Dave and a pretzel. Salt off the pretzel with Dave. Uncle Dave. What's up with the tent? I have a tent here. So I've got salt off the pretzels in a tent. Is that you? Is that you, New York? It's not you? It's a tent? I got a tent like I'm camping or something. I don't camp, so I have a tent here. Are you sure?
Dark.
All right, who takes the pretzel, the salt off their pretzel and has a tent? Or camps? Or does something?
No.
Who's
I'm like, I'm dipping it in mustard. I don't know.
Maybe he likes it.
Did he do that?
He does.
Oh, okay.
She told me today she doesn't like mustard.
Okay, so mustard. Okay, right, mustard. I got salt and off pretzel and mustard. I just awesome. I'm going with those whatever I got.
You know what? So know your dad is here then, okay?
Because I also work at a Dairy Queen.
You work at Dairy Queen, so no mustard there. No, I have Dairy Queen with mustard.
Oh, I'm going to
have to try it. All right. Anyway, let's go with your dad now. So what do you want to know? You have a question for your dad. We're getting a little too chatty.
How did he go? On his certificate, he said that he overdosed.
Yeah, I have. Was it a medical condition? I feel like it was a medical condition. I don't feel like he was like did this on purpose. I think it was more of a just kind of like he wanted to just trying to ease the pain. And I don't think whatever it was, it has a medical condition and it wasn't on purpose. So that's what he had.
Heart problems, and then he was also
okay. So he was either probably self-medicating or something, but it was a medical condition. He's saying that he was trying not to feel the pain. Whatever that means to you, that's what he's giving me as far as that for an answer for you. Do you have another question for him besides that? Or anybody else?
My sister's lost son, she had a stillbirth to him. His name would have been John.
And what's the question?
Why did he?
It wasn't the right time. He's going to come back when it's time. Okay? He's saying divine timing, and he's going to come back probably within 1 or 2 years. Okay? He might come back sooner. Because, I got the word sooner, but I'm trying to give myself a little leeway here. Okay, so you don't go back, it's been a year. It's 12 months and 1 day, and it's not happening yet. Okay, so he's giving me a little time here, okay? I think it's going to be sooner because he's saying it's sooner, but it was all about divine timing. I don't, she needs to check her pH balance or whatever that stuff is that they, all that hormone stuff, okay? Check that, make sure she's all kosher and all that, okay? So I think there might have been something there, okay, that maybe she needs to pay attention to her health a little bit more. And then once she gets that all balanced, because they're saying balance, then it's going to happen. Okay, so not to worry. He hasn't left. And your name?
Paul.
Hi, Paul. How are you?
Good.
All right. Is there anybody you'd like to talk to? Or were you dragged here also? You were dragged here. Are you sure there's nobody you want to talk to?
My grandmother.
Okay, was he a cowboy or something? Did he like a lasso or a lasso? I got a rope. Are you sure?
Pretty sure.
Okay, then who has the lasso? Who like to play with ropes or something or swirl a rope around? Nobody. Somebody with you? Okay, so the lasso belongs to you? Okay. Did you lasso him? Is that what happened? Oh, you were in the rodeo. Okay, all right. So now, who would be connected to you as far as that is concerned? Who did you learn that from? Your mom. Is your mom?
Oh.
She's on the other side.
Oh, she's
okay. Yeah, she is. So know that. Now, do you like bling? Are you like the real blingy person?
Diamonds.
Okay. Okay. Did you inherit the bling?
Yeah.
Okay. Because she's saying bling.
Yeah.
Yeah, and she's got you all glittery and shiny.
Oh.
Okay. All right. So if you haven't bought the bling, you need to get some more bling.
I have bling.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now, is there anything in particular? What's the marquee? Is there a marquee? Is that the design, like a sharp?
It's like a circle. It's like a bow. It's a diamond necklace, and it has, about the same length as yours, but it has like a...
Did you just get something then with the dot? It's like sharp edges.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you did just get something. Okay, she was there and she saw that. Okay, so she's right there with you and she's acknowledging that. What's up with the Jell-O?
What?
Jell-O? You're did you do something about Jell-O? Do you like Jell-O? Do you wrestle with Jell-O? Okay, I'm getting Jell-O. They're showing me green and red Jell-O. It's like, and they're showing me Jell-O. It's like big leg on a plate here. Okay, then that's your grandmother. No, that's your grandmother is here. Okay, and she's, I guess, making you Jell-O still. I don't know. Or eat Jell-O. Is there a holiday coming up? She's making me feel like there's a holiday coming up for you. That you, she would make this special Jell-O mold.
Birthday?
Jell-O. All right. So know that Grandma is here. Okay. So you didn't want to talk to me. Grandma's here. All right. And Mom is here, and she's with you. Do you have a question for her?
No.
Your brother.
Not very young. Okay. Hold on to it because it's going to make sense to you because I don't know
But yet I want to eat ice cream. It's like, I feel like, ooh, I got this cool vanilla ice cream. But it's not vanilla. It's more of a, like a caramel color. Did she eat caramel ice cream or something?
Probably at some point. It wasn't a favorite.
Okay, well then, I'm not going to force it. We're not going to go there then.
Yeah.
Okay? You just hold on to that just in case. Because I feel like I got this little swirl of ice cream. Did she make ice cream? Did she like ice cream? Did she have like an ice cream maker? Alright. Alright, we're not. Anybody have an ice cream maker? Like caramel ice cream or a caramel colored ice cream? Alright, I'm just gonna go. Okay, just trying to call out to anybody. Alright, so now we're talking to your sister now. What do you want to know from your sister? You want to know your dad? Or her dad? But that's your dad
my
too,
dad.
Huh?
Yeah.
You can't, don't discount that he was your dad. Okay? Just because you weren't born to him doesn't mean you don't belong to him. Okay? Because he's getting a little antsy here, a little irritated with that, okay?
No.
Because I'm getting irritated, so that means he's getting irritated because he's coming in through, he's coming strong. So Billy, he is here, okay? And that she's with him, for sure. Okay? And that they're... Did he, like, balance you guys on his knee or something? Is that, like, something, like, the both of you had to be, like, on each knee or something? I'm getting, like, a balancing on a knee.
She was already,
We don't have to bounce on knees then. Okay, so are we bouncing on knees here? Are we bouncing on knees here? Do we bounce on knees? Do we bounce anybody on knees? Pay attention. Remember. Okay? I feel like I'm bouncing on a knee here. You bounce your knee?
My knees.
Okay, all right, so you guys are connected then? No? Okay, so they're just connected.
We were
just sitting next to you. Okay. You work together. Okay, so there is a connection there, so your energy is connected. Okay, so do you know that we were talking about?
My nephew, Johnny?
Yeah, no, there's somebody else here that was watching you bounce your knees on your knee.
My dad's
okay. So know that there's somebody here with you for that and recognizes that and watches that happen.
I always do this too.
Bouncing at the knee. Okay.
That's why I
bounce
my legs a lot too, so
I can train for it. Okay, so do that your dad's here, then he's watching over you. Okay. And ease up on the anxiety, you're okay. And I don't know if you're in a relationship or not, but he's saying with love. Okay? So.
Tall, dark, and tone.
You're giving me answers.
Or is he already in there?
You're saying soon. Be ready. So that means you have to know what you want to manifest in your life. Okay? So get ready. And your name, huh?
I'm Tony.
Hi, Tony. Is there anybody you'd like to talk to?
My coworker.
Your coworker, okay. And what's your coworker's name?
Sharon.
Was Sharon impatient? I'm getting a tapping of the shoe.
No, she's
impatient
with me.
Was there somebody impatient with her? Are you impatient? I'm getting this. No? Now I'm getting impatient. Just kidding. Does that fit with your sister?
No.
Because I'm getting the energy here as I'm looking at you guys, I'm getting that energy. So is there somebody around you that's connected to you that is, are you impatient?
Mom. No.
You're not impatient? All right, no one wants to claim this.
No, I'm so laid back, who cares?
All right, so who was the impatient one in your life then? Because that I got impatient and I'm over here. I mean, I could be over here too, but I feel like I'm really over here when I'm looking at you guys. I kind of want to like be like tap my foot. I'm impatient, or is that you? Am I going with you? Okay, all right.
Situation.
Yeah. It's time to meditate. Calm down. Om. Okay? So whatever you need to do to relax.
I work two jobs. And so I don't know how to.
Okay, then you need to relax. Find a day off where you can just kind of do what you need to take care of you. Because your cup is empty. You need to fill your cup. Okay? And your sister says the same thing for you. Do you give too much? Are you really generous?
Yes.
All right, stop. Okay? You need to fill your own cup. Stop. Maybe this is where she's getting impatient with you. Okay? So because I've got this impatient, I've got this tapping thing, I'm getting irritated because you're not paying attention. You need to pay attention to yourself and what you need. Because you also have to watch out for your cortisol levels. Okay? All right? So, and I don't know what magnesium is for you. I'm not a doctor. I don't know. So magnesium also will help. Don't know what you're doing, but magnesium.
I got some shit going on right now.
And you want to talk to your coworker? That's kind of crazy. That's really good. Like,
or my
sisters.
Old boss.
Oh, your old boss.
He just like a second dad.
Okay. What's up with the green bottles? She showed me a green bottle. What does that mean?
She was drunk.
Well, I'm glad she's here.
I mean, why wouldn't she be?
You tell we love each other.
She does love you.
Yeah,
but she loves you now. Okay, she loved you the best she could then. And she said she's had her soul journey and lessons to learn. And unfortunately you had to suffer the consequences.
Right.
And so
when she died, she
she went to both my sisters and said, this isn't what it's cracked up to be. I can't wash my hands. I can't wash my hands. This isn't what it's cracked up to be. And so my sister told me, she said, Mom, babe, you better talk to Mom. And I said, no, Mom's never talked to me.
And Mom is talking to you.
Okay. But
roommate.
This is going back 8 years ago.
Roommate. She showed me the ripples. Okay, that's what I was seeing, the ripples. Okay? That's why I was seeing ripples with you guys. She's here. Okay. You need to forgive her, not for her, but for you.
I've forgiven for me.
You still hold on to it.
No, I am.
You still hold on to it, so you need to let it go. Because that was her soul journey, and you take her off the pedestal of expectations of what you expected her as a mother to be. She couldn't do that.
No,
she couldn't measure up.
No.
And she's paying for it now.
Yes.
Your father, you were close to your father? There's a gentleman here that says he's like a father figure, that he's like close to you.
I was close to him.
He sends you feathers, or you have something of feathers that is like that is connected to him somehow. And so just know that when you do see this feather, just get hit with a feather. Like this.
No.
Pay attention now, okay? Because he's trying to give you messages with feathers. Okay, I don't know if you're going to get hit with a feather, you're going to trip on a feather, I don't know what this is, but a feather is coming and it's Dad. Okay? And know that he is your guardian angel, and he will be around when you need him. Okay, and I'm gonna leave that with you, honey. I hope that helps. I'm sorry about your mom. Yeah, what do you want to know? Not much? So, I'm gonna walk on by you, what are we doing here? What's the building blocks for? I've got like little blocks.
That's his trade.
Huh? You build stuff all day? Okay, so building blocks? Okay. So I feel like these are children's blocks, though. Are you building blocks? Or are you like a... There's a baby coming, apparently. We keep messing with baby over here in this section. I feel like I'm messing with blocks. There's blocks. So be prepared and ready for that.
Which child?
Which child? Who's the 27-year-old? I got the number 27. I don't know if that one's back. So if that helps you out, I don't know. I got 50-50 chance of being right, though, right? And your name, huh?
Elaine.
Hi, Elaine. And who would you like to talk to? Your mom? And what would you like to know from your mom? Because she's saying, sweep it up. Don't sweep it under the rug. Sweep it up. Does that make sense to you? Not really? It will, because there's something that you're trying to sweep under the rug. She's like, there's an elephant in the room. Stop trying to ignore the elephant in the room. Does that make sense to you now? Okay. You're doing something. You're sweeping something under the rug here. I don't know if that or you need to sweep over vacuum. I don't know. Did she like to like sweep under things under the rug then? Sweeping under the rug, you know, elephant in the room. Was she constantly cleaning? Did you not measure up to her cleaning standards or something? Because she's like, clean it up. Actually, don't sweep it under the rug. This is something that she keeps going on about, so she won't stop showing me that she's sweeping something. So she's sweeping something. Okay, so maybe she's kind of angry about that. I don't know. Do you have Irish lace? Do you know what Irish lace is? Cobwebs. So she's saying clean out the cobwebs and then have the Irish lace. Oh, you did? Okay, so there you go. All right, so she saw that, then she was watching it clean. There you go. So now that Mom is here, do you have a question for her besides her and the fact she wants you to clean, I guess? right, some Sagittarius, but yes. Okay. And they've taken on, all three of them have taken on a guardian angel role for you. I get wings on all of them, so I don't know what you've been doing that you need like three guardian angels around you, but they got you covered. Does that make sense? Yes?
I have angels.
Okay, so you've got angels everywhere. Okay, all right. That makes sense then, because you've got a lot of angels around you. So know that they're there watching over you, and yes, they are together. Okay, so they're watching over you. Still, you're sipping something out of the rug. So pay attention to that. Hold on to that. That's going to make sense to you later. Okay? So stop it. Whatever you're doing, stop. And you just need to just face it on and not like get a hold of that elephant. Like, don't even ignore the elephant. You can't put the rug on the elephant. Okay? That's what they're saying here. Okay? It's too big. You have to face it. And it's not as scary as you think. So when this opportunity comes up, or when this situation comes up, and you remember this, this is what she's telling you. Okay? Because it's not cleaning. I mean, maybe you need to clean. I don't know. But, you know, this is something where she's like, don't sweep it under the rug. So I don't know what you're doing, huh? But she won't let me stop saying this. Can you accept this, please? Thank you. And what's your name, huh?
Lisha. Oh, are you talking to me?
Yeah, you.
Lisha.
Lisha?
Yeah.
Hi, Lisha. My name is Onae.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, hon.
I think you were talking about my dad earlier.
Was I?
His name's David.
Okay. So
his mother's name is Jane.
Oh, did I say Jane?
No, you said Jay.
Oh, okay. All right, there you go.
She was a waitress, and she wore a uniform with an apron, comfortable shoes.
Okay.
She made fruitcake with those horrible glassine cherries, and we camped my entire childhood in a tent camper.
So you got your messages then.
I talk to him all the time, yeah. So.
So now that they are here in the question, do you have a question for him?
No, they answer me.
Then I'll leave that with you.
Thank you.
And you, my dear.
My name is Sharon.
Sharon. Hi, Sharon. Nice
Hello.
To meet you. Do you have a question? Yes. You have a question. Tell me your questions. I've got question marks all over you. What are you doubting?
Well, I guess my husband.
You're doubting your husband?
Oh. I'm doubting that I'm not seeing him.
Oh. Well, that's because he's not letting you see him, okay? But you hear him. So pay attention, because you get the tingle around your ear. All right, get the tickle around your ear. It's almost like he's like caressing your ear. Does he caress your ear? Because he used to caress your ear, huh?
Yeah, my neck.
Yeah. So pay attention, he's caressing your ear. Okay. And he sits next to you on the bed. So pay attention when you feel like you're not alone. Because you're not. Not in a creepy way. He's just loving you and letting you know he is there. You're not seeing him, but he is there.
I hear him all the time when I'm with her and when I'm not with her. We've been friends for a long time, but I hear him all the time. And yeah, if he's sitting on the bed, it isn't a creepy place.
Okay.
Do
you have any questions?
No.
No, he's here. And the ear, what's going on about the ear? He likes your ear. Do you like your earlobes or something? Do you have pretty ears? I can't see them. He really likes your ears. I will move on. Who would you like to talk to? I'm not playing this because they all came here too.
My grandma.
Your grandmother? Okay. And what would you like to know from your grandmother? What's up with the baby bottle? I got like this weird nipple-y baby bottle. Are you pregnant?
No. I hope not.
Did you just have a baby? Did someone have a baby?
I did have a baby. I mean, you know, like a year or so ago.
Okay. And she was already passed by then, huh?
There's this one that was passed. Yes.
That one that's passed? That was passed then? She gave me this sign, this symbol, and that represents the fact that she held a baby before it came here to you. Or the girl, I don't know.
Boy.
Yes. Yeah, because it's making me feel to keep. So, don't know that she was there holding him before she came to you. Okay. Is there a question that you have for the other woman that you want me to ask? Because there's just so many babies.
There's so many babies? you know, I really don't think there is.
Okay, what's number 27 mean to you?
I don't know.
Not your 27. You're 27. There's like an arrow through your head with number 27. Are you 27? You can't be 27.
Travis?
Travis is 27?
Well, maybe.
You don't know?
I don't know.
Oh.
It doesn't mean his high school number.
All right, well, then you just hold on to 27 of the baby bottle and know that your grandmother was there holding up the baby's soul when before he came here. Okay? I'm going to leave that with you, and I hope that helps. You, my dear. What's your name?
Kathleen.
Hi, Kathleen.
Hi.
Do you have a question for me, hon? You guys ate pizza. Was it pepperoni?
Mine was.
It was a little bit.
I don't like it. It hurts me. So who would you like to talk to, Kevin?
My dad.
Your dad? And what would you like to ask him? You don't know? He's showing me, I don't know what this is, I'm assuming it's a necklace. Did you make him a necklace or something? Was there a necklace made for you? Because I feel like there's like a little bead, and then a little string or something, and then a little bead, and then I don't know what I'm looking at here. I'm assuming it's a necklace. I could be all wrong, but it's like a bead, it's a round thing, then there's a little string or something, and then a little round thing. Am I getting anything here?
This is sausage.
What? It's a sausage? That's a sausage?
That's weird to say, but yeah, he used to light this little mechanical thing, and it
and
was
it looked like that?
Harrington. It was a song.
Oh, it was a song?
And then he used to, like, the little man used to make this sausage.
Oh. So that makes sense to you then?
Yeah, it's
okay. Good. Okay, well, then there you go. I'll get back with you, and I hope that helps.
Okay.
you're Italian. Have you ever heard of sausage like that? You. I'm talking to you.
Yes, my father makes sausage.
Okay. So I was meant to come to you for sausage, apparently. So, yeah. You didn't keep up the tradition. You need to keep up the tradition.
No, but I found the recipe.
Okay. There you go. Dad's here.
You
so it's Aunt Beth. Give it to your daughter?
I'm going to.
Okay. Yeah, you have to keep up with the tradition, okay? Don't lose the tradition of the family. Are you Sicilian?
No.
Yeah? Okay. So don't, that's validation then. This is for you. Beverly's here, okay? No, she's here. She's bringing up the bathroom seat. And we'll leave that with you.
Yeah, leave that with me.
And you, my dear. What's your name?
Elena.
Hi, Elena. How are you going?
Good.
All right. So who would you like to talk to?
My mom.
Your mom. Okay. Hopscotch. Does that mean anything to you? I want to do like this thing with chalk and hopscotch. What is that? Did you just do something with hopscotch?
No. I mean, I'm a teacher, so there's hopscotch stuff.
Okay, so you're a teacher and you do hopscotch stuff?
Sure.
So sure. Are we going to just make it a fit or?
Yeah.
Oh, I just got my audience. Yeah, we're talking about buttons. I need a seamstress.
She's good.
Yeah.
She's good.
children is there number six, Louise? Are you planning on having a Louise? Because I think a number six is coming.
Cool. Number six, Louise, is my daughter, my older sister's daughter.
Oh, your sister's daughter.
She left her very young.
So there's a six Louise, so know that the number six Louise is here also. Okay, so you're not alone, and neither is your sister. Let your sister know that our younger sister.
Where's my sister?
Where?
No, we are
seeing
my sister.
Oh, okay, all right. So know that, that she's here also, okay? Six Louise. So she's here, okay? What did you just celebrate? You just celebrated something. You're shouting something out. She's got. So you should be shouting this out. You did something that you need to be shouting it out and be very proud of yourself. What did you just do?
I got a job promotion.
Good job.
Good job. There you go. Okay, so she's telling me that there's something here, you're going to have a new idea. You need to move on it and get act. And once you have this idea and you know and you feel it, this is what it's going to be, like this is a really good idea, you need to jump on it, okay? Because you're showing me the Four of Swords upside down, which means you have to jump on this idea. Because it's going to be a good money maker for you, okay? Mm-hmm. So don't delay when the idea comes and pops in your head. You feel like you know that you know that you know, mm-hmm. Okay? And you, my dear, what's your name?
Michelle.
Michelle. Hi, Michelle.
Hi.
And who would you like to talk to?
My brother-in-law.
Brother-in-law. Okay. He was nice.
He was great.
Oh, good. That's nice. Yeah. I might even want that. I'm crazy about my in-laws.
Oh.
Do you have a Steve next to you? No? Okay. All right. I guess it's just my brother-in-law. I gave you the name Steve, so is there an S name that's connected to you? It can be alive. It could be O crossed over. It's okay. You got a Steve here. No? Okay. So we're talking to your brother-in-law. Okay. What would you like to know about your brother-in-law? Alright, well, who's the fisherman?
I'm surrounded by lots of fishermen. In the daily and personal.
Oh, okay. Then we've got fishermen around you. So he knows that and recognizes that and acknowledging that. So know that, are the boys, do they fish too?
They have been, yeah.
Okay, then know he's there with them when they are. Okay. And do you have any other questions besides? He says, is there a purple worm? I'm like getting a purple worm. I give them say you need to use the purple worm.
More than I do about
yeah, okay, tell them purple worm. I don't know what that means. I'm not a fisherman. Those looks scare the crap out of me.
I don't do it myself.
I'm always afraid, like, I'm going to, like, hook myself or something.
It's dangerous.
Yeah, it's dangerous. That's a dangerous sport. Is there anybody else you'd like to talk to?
I mean, lots of people, but if I had one other person, specifically my grandpa.
Was he a fisherman, too?
No.
No? Okay. Did he make fishing lures or fishing little things? I got, like, little furry things, and I'm winding string around something, and it's like furry, and I'm winding. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Well.
Okay, so well, maybe this is your brother-in-law still then? Fishing? Do you do this?
Nope.
Oh. Then they're all acknowledging fishing stuff for you. So I don't know. Maybe get your nephew's something to fish with, a purple worm and a little thingy. A fly thingy? A fly thingy. A purple worm and fly fishing thing. That's get them their own little kit.
Yeah.
Get them their little kit from their father. Okay, as a gift from their father. And
that was you and that house. And you, my dear.
Well, we talked about
this. Oh, we already talked, okay.
Yeah, my grandma and my dad would be the ones that I talked to.
Okay. That was a third one.
There's a lot.
The third one that passed. Who's the third one that passed?
I mean, there's a few.
They all passed at the same time, number three. It's a third one that passed. I don't know why they're saying it, but they're making it say, third one that passed. Grandmother?
Sorry,
okay, it's a female. Yeah, I've got a female. It's your grandmother. So know that she is there with you. And what's up with the knees? Did she have bad knees? Do you have bad knees? Were you on your knees? What am I thinking about my knees?
I tore my ACL.
Okay.
My dad has bad knees too.
Okay, so know your dad is here also because he's making sure I'm focusing on the knees. So know that your dad is here too and your grandmother also. Do you have any questions for them?
No.
I'm going to go with you, and I hope that helps. You look bored. You all right? You're a woman.
She's not
a woman. Oh, she's not your woman? She's not your woman. Oh, Alex.
Yes.
Alex. Who's Bud? What's his name? Bud, or the word Bud? What does that mean? Bud. Rosebud. I don't know. Bud, something Bud. I got Bud here. Bud. Hold on to that because that might be for Alex, okay? I don't know if I'm drinking a Bud or I got like a. I don't know what I'm doing here with this word Bud, but it's like I'm seeing a brown bottle. I got a Bud. I don't know if this is your Bud, but it's a Bud. Did a Bud pass away? Buds?
Alex is in your business.
Oh, okay.
It's not Bud Light.
Okay.
But he drinks a
chicken. Okay, that's a chicken. So who would you like to start with?
Yeah, my dad's on my mind.
Your dad's on your mind? His name wasn't Bud. We drink Bud. You know what, like I'm seeing, you know what they're showing me? I don't know what these things are called. I mean, I do, but I don't remember it. It's a stick with these little furry things. Those little soft furry things. Oh, Pussy Willow. Yeah, that's such a horrible name. What does that mean? Also, I'm seeing green sequins too. So it's like red and green. So she's seeing
the red glittery stuff, but I'm feeling like they're showing me also green too. And for some reason, sequence keeps coming into my head. Just put the sequence in my head. So if it's not making sense, hold on to that. Ask your mother, because it might make sense to her. So there's another color. It's not just red glittery stuff. It's like almost like a green sequence. And they're showing me like the little flat little things with a little hole in between them. They just sew it. That's sequence, right? They have a shop. So they know sequence. So here's something about sequence. I don't know what that means unless there's something in sequence. We're going to play a word game, I guess, here, sequence. Something is in sequence. So there's something coming up here. And also know that your mother is, she's also a lighthouse. And what that represents to me, when I say lighthouse, it means she has the ability to see and feel others that are not there. That you can't see, okay? So, but you also have this inheritance in your family, so it's not hallucination time. These are messages coming through. I don't know if your mom wants to admit that or not.
Oh, absolutely not.
Yeah.
She's not that person.
Yeah, but she is that person. So, no, because I keep getting lighthouse. So, and you have that ability, and you need to open up, because then it'll come and flow easier for you, and you won't feel so frightened. So that anxiety you get is your dad coming through. Okay? And I'm going to leave that with you, honey, if that helps. And you, not her boyfriend. What?
I'm not a boyfriend. I'm not a boyfriend.
It's Were you dragged here, or would you like a message?
No, I came with her.
Okay. Who would you like to talk to, honey?
My grandfather.
Showing me, were there many people around the bed when he did pass? Is this when you spoke to him? Did you whisper this in his ear?
No.
Who whispered in his ear? Because I feel like somebody was, there were people all around the bed and someone whispered in his ear.
There were people on the property, but not around him. If they had their moments of peace, you know, it's different. Like, we all wanted it separately.
Okay, then who did pass that did have that experience? Because that's who I've got here.
My grandmother would have been like that. I was not present. But there were several around.
Someone whispered in her ear then. I have somebody whispering in the ear, leaning over and whispering in the ear. I don't know who this is, but they feel like they have not had enough closure yet, besides you, have not had enough closure yet. And she is saying here, it's okay. I don't know who had a hard time letting go, but
did you hear that?
I wasn't there when she passed.
There were like three or four people, like no, four or five people there. Someone was standing at the end of the bed.
I mean, that's where I spoke to my grandfather.
Nerve?
Yeah.
They won't let go, so I'm like, that's why I keep talking about this.
It's been the injury separate of that, but it's been ongoing for about 6 years. It also cost me a lot of money. So yes, it's a long time.
It's just par for the course.
So do know he is here. I don't know what the message is that necessarily you are hoping for, but do know he is here. He's going to sign the symbols and we'll just run stuff around.
No, sorry.
He's signed into the room.
He did that too.
Oh, he did that too. So then there you go. There's your messages. Anything else, my dear? Really like digging in there, like getting his thumb in there. That really talks to that. Yeah, he's
just
and Uncle Dave.
Oh, hey.
Yeah. Uncle Dave, you want to talk to Uncle Dave?
No.
No. How may I help you on my?
Yeah, let's go ahead and go with Dad.
We'll go with Dad?
Yeah.
All right. Who am I going to ask Dad?
Just man one really at peace. That he's at peace.
New York, come on.
That he is at peace.
Okay, thank you. New York is
at peace.
New York is loud, right? Or are you not from the right part of New York?
Washington Heights!
Was there a problem with his tombstone or something? Because I got I'm at the gravesite here, and I feel like I'm expected to be there, and I don't want to be there because it's like I've moved on.
No, I've gone to his gravesite, just not really expected to see him there.
Okay, he's not hanging out. He's not hanging out
there.
He's not hanging out. Did he bowl? Did he like bowling? Who like bowling then? Who like bowling? Oh, you like bowling.
My grandfather.
Oh, you like bowling? Okay, so we're still there. He's still bowling. Did his bowling favorite, did he have a favorite bowling ball?
We had custom bowling balls that he bought for me as a gift when I
was 16. Was one with a swirly color?
His was like a gown.
A gown, okay,
like
yeah.
Yeah, black.
So yeah, no, grandpa's here. Or yeah. So okay, back to not Uncle Dave.
That is so cool.
Dad's doing his thing. He's not at the. He keeps doing the gravestone, so you don't need to go there. It's okay. He's not there. He's off doing his thing. Whatever that is, he's not even letting me know. So I keep going back to the bowling ball. Maybe he's bowling. I don't know. Maybe he picked it up or something. I don't know. Maybe you didn't know it was a secret kind of thing that he had, a little fantasy. What did you do, Dad? What did you do?
What did he do?
Yeah.
Oh, he's a doctor.
He was a what?
Doctor.
He was a doctor.
Yeah.
Wow. He's not doing that anymore.
No,
he keeps showing me the grave. So did you just do something to his gravesite, or he keeps showing me that? Like, so I don't know what this is. I'd be like, he's got me stuck here. I'm stuck here.
The family is stuck in the graveyard.
The family is.
Yeah, his parents and his brother and sister-in-law consistently go back. back.
Okay.
Go back there.
Yeah, because he's not there. He's right there in the living room with you guys. Okay, I don't
know. Wait, that's us.
I've got like five people here, and he's right in the middle.
Wait,
so I don't know
what
that means.
With us.
There's five people.
If you want it to be you, then yes. If we want it to be five other people, then yeah.
Well, he's got a picture of him in his house where we hang out. The five of us.
The five of you.
Alex, who's not here, all twice a week for the last decade. The same picture.
So there he is. He knows where he's at. That's where he's at. So do you have a question for him besides if he's at peace? Because apparently he's hanging out with you guys and all five of you.
Can you tell him I'm sorry about last weekend?
Is
a 2 hour flight?
There are
two hour flights, okay. Because it's 2 hour. So in that layover, is it like a 2 hour layover too?
I think so.
It's like a two.
Hour and a half layover.
It's probably a 2 hour layover because I'm getting 2-2-2. So I don't know what that means, but we're just going to hold on to it or play the game.
I don't remember those things. I just know I'm going to
remember to play the picture.
You know, I'm going to Vegas.
So. All right, so there you go.
I'm going to Vegas.
There you go.
And hope for the
chair.
666.
No, let's not do that. Okay. Are we going to share? Are we going to like?
Well, we're big. Two numbers. Everything. 22.
Okay. Thank you. who would your sister like to talk to? What's your name, hon? So I can talk to you.
Mrs.
What?
Megan.
Megan. Giving me a sharp pain in my back. I don't know what that necessarily means. It's on my right side. I'm getting a sharp pain in my back. I'm getting a pain in my head. I don't know what, did he have an accident of some sort or something? Because, or is there like a violent thing here? Because I've got the pain in my back and then I got the pain in my head. And they're on opposite sides.
I was told you had the brain aneurysm.
Did something happen to his right side, though, after that happened? Did he fall on his right side or something? Because I have a pain in my back, and then I have the pain in the head. What would cause the pain in the back, the right side? I don't know. What is this right here? What is that?
Kidneys. Kidneys.
Is that a kidney thing?
Liver.
I don't know.
Liver.
Kidneys are high?
Kidneys.
It's like right here. He's giving me the pain right here. And then I've got the pain over here. So the aneurysm is real then. Okay? I don't know what the right pain is on the side here, the back. But there's something there. So I don't know what that is. Did he have an accident? Was there some kind of injury before that or something? I don't know what this is, but I'm feeling like it's a sharp pain. Does that make sense to you? No, not at all. Okay. But the pain in the head means something to you. Okay. Do you want to ask him anything else? Are they going back to your back too? Okay, so this is, he's recognizing this is what's happening with you. Okay, so I don't know what his signs are for you other than you need to pay attention to yourself, okay? And get this checked out, unless this is heartache that I'm feeling. I'm feeling like I'm being stabbed in the chest. I'm having a hard time breathing. So if this is your warning, get some counseling. It's okay to get counseling. It's okay to talk about it. And I don't know what this back pain is. I don't know, like, have you been having a hard time breathing? Or do you have asthma or something? Or okay. So you might want to get that checked out just because he's giving me this feeling and it hurts. Okay? But know that he loves you and he's right there watching over you and he wants you to take care of yourself. Now, we got fingers being flashed at me. On my time?
Yeah.
Okay. Can I get everybody? Yeah, I didn't get somebody?
I feel like the message that you gave to me about the cherries and David and the J was meant for her. And so I wanted to see if anybody could come through with that. We'll be talking to
you. Okay, so you want more?
I just feel like it was. Do you feel like it was for you? Because I just felt like once you started talking about the cherries and the David and the, what was the other name?
Jane.
That it just totally felt
so
like
then,
it was.
So would you like to talk to him?
I wanted to see if my grandpa would come through.
Okay, what do you want to know about your grandpa?
My grandpa.
Oh, your grandfather.
Yes.
Okay. What would you like to ask your grandfather?
I don't really know. I just love him a lot.
Please get yourself checked out, hon. They're still letting me that pain. So if this is just your heartache and sorrow, it's okay to talk about it and let it go. Release it. It's okay. But you need to pay attention to yourself because you are a giver. And you need to start paying attention to yourself and start receiving. It's okay to ask for help. So I don't know what you're holding on to, but it's okay to ask for help when you're saying that. Really making it hard for me to breathe here, so please accept this message. And it's not a corset. Grandpa. Alright, so Grandpa put like screws or things and collecting some jars.
Yes, pennies.
Okay, yeah. We got jars here full of stuff. He likes to collect things. Did he collect vegetable cans too or something? I've got vegetable cans here. Did he put things in vegetable cans?
How could I know? I'll have to ask my grandma.
Yeah, he's got the cans too, so I don't know what he's doing with the cans, but I've got the jars, so now that Grandpa is here with the jars. So, did you keep one of the jars?
No, but when I was little, I used to throw pennies out of them.
Do you have a question for him besides that?
Is he still with my grandma? Does he stick with her still? She's still alive.
I'm going to say yes because he's showing me something in the house. I feel like I'm in the house.
Okay.
Does he have a special, like, almost like a rough woven fabric chair? I feel like it's like, I like Egyptian cotton. So this is not Egyptian cotton. It's like, I feel like it's like a... Weaving.
Okay.
It's rough weaving.
He had an office.
Yeah, it was in his office. Okay. It's not wicker. It's fabric. It's not
kind
sticks.
Of plasticky, or is it like that?
It's fabric. It's rough fabric. And it's like.
Like the old 70s, like the woven
I forget words.
Okay.
It's like a tick sack, yeah, like a burlap sack, kind of fabric. Is that what that, but it wasn't a burlap sack, but that kind of fabric it was
I'm
about.
I'm not sure, but I'll have to ask my grandma.
Okay, because I feel like that's where he's at. He's like walking around his chair. Did he have like that kind of a, it's like he won't stop with the fabric. It's like rough, and I almost kind of went, like, he's showing my aunt and uncle's furniture that lasts in the room. It was like Ethan Allen furniture.
It was my grandma used to cover it in plastic, so we weren't supposed to sit on it.
But it was his special chair, so he felt the fabric in this chair. He's making sure I can feel the fabric. And it was my aunt's Ethan Allen kind of furniture. So I don't know what this chair is, but he's walking around it. So I'm going to have to say yes, he's still walking around, and I think she hears him walking around.
Okay.
I'm going to go with that because that's what he's making me feel like. He's like walking around, and she kind of feels like the energy is right there. And that's what I'm going to go with. Is she okay?
I don't know.
This one?
Yeah, that one. She was getting really bad anxiety. I think like her mom has senses, and I think that she is too, and I don't think she knows how to handle it.
She gets a little overwhelmed.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's when spirit kind of comes to you.
Yeah.
Okay. And you just ask them, work with my energy. So I don't need to work. You don't give me anxiety. Work with my energy. You can talk to them just like they are people, because that's what they are. They're souls that were here at one time, and they're connecting with us again. And she's probably got that energy where she is a lighthouse, where they will come to her. She's sensitive. So in that anxiety, so where you can't breathe, and then you say, that's when spirit comes in and lets you know that they're there. And you can say, okay, acknowledge it, and then say, now work with my energy. And it will smooth out. And if she can't handle it beyond that, she says release. So they will let go. Yes, ma'am.
I have a question.
So they will let go. Yes, ma'am.
I have a quick question.
Yeah.
I know we're playing people who passed away, but I don't feel any real strong connection with any of them for whatever reason. Is there anybody around me?
They're all around you. Okay, because they're showing these squirrels. Okay. But it's, you are so busy. I don't know what you're doing, but you are so busy that you don't even pay attention. So that's why they're there, but you're so busy you're not paying attention. And so all you have to do is just take a moment and focus on one of them and ask them to give you a sign when you are wanting to talk to them. They will give you the sign. And what they're telling me here is that when you really want to talk to one of them in particular, ask them to come to your dreams, and that's how they will start giving you messages right there. So when you're dreaming about them, it's not just a dream, it is a visitation. Start writing your dreams down. Get a dream journal. Because when you wake up in the middle of the night, you get that dream, you write it down, and you're going to have a message. And they're going to say, they're going to probably put something ridiculous in that dream to let you remember what it is, the message. Okay? So if they put, like, a pink elephant with purple toenails, it's so cute. It's not, they just want you to remember and have a trigger to remember that message and that they were there.
Is that the same with your spirit animal? Like, we had a dog just pass in May, and I just feel like she's jumping on the bed, and she's right there. I can't see her, but I can feel her.
We're all souls, and we're all energy, and we're all connected, and that's how she's coming through and listening to you. I picked up on someone's word last week.
Yep, she sure did.
I didn't realize it was a bird, but I just get sprayed with water and all kinds of
what I'm feeling is really real, right?
Yes, it's real.
It's they not my dreams. It's
no,
real.
No, they're real.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. And our pets actually, you feel it, not even on your bed, but you feel it around your feet and your legs. Like right around here, you get brushes of energy around your legs. And you know who it is when they have it. Yes, ma'am.
Am I in my house?
Do you want me?
I don't know. I feel like I have people like watching me. But then I turn and nobody's there. Quite often.
We all have that ability.
Okay.
Everybody can pick a name, but not everybody is, what's his name? Gordon Ramsay. Okay. But if you want to be, you can open up, what's his name? Gordon Ramsay. So, yes, you can be a lighthouse if you choose to be. Don't want to, you can close up also. So we all have choices. So yes, we can all have the ability to do this. We're all energy connected. But if you choose not to, if you get caused too much anxiety, or you don't want to, you just don't want to even deal with it, you can close off. We all have those abilities. We have free choice, free will. Yes, my dear.
How come I never can do it to my dad?
Is he here?
I personally
tile. And she's telling you she tiled.
quiet, okay? So, and apparently she doesn't want, you know, she wants to yell at him, so he's not going to make himself known around here.
Definitely.
How does she know I don't talk to her?
What's up with the red truck?
I told you.
Does that make sense to you? Does the red truck mean something? I don't know who this is, but they showed me a red truck. Okay. Are you getting a red truck? Did you buy a red truck? Did you make a red truck? Did you? Did he have a red truck? What's up with the Jeep? You own a Jeep? One of those Jeep trucky things?
No.
No? Okay. That's weird. Yeah. Yeah, don't get one of those. You have batteries? Oh,
yeah, they're batteries.
It's not good. They're definitely not good. It's kind of like the platypus of like the truck room. Yeah.
Wait, I think you're raffle for one of those. Okay, I think for a raffle for one of those deepy trucky things.
And you are just amazing and you probably will win it.
Yes.
You have a 50-50 chance of being right. So. All right, thank you everybody so much for joining me here tonight. If you have any questions, I'm here to answer.